Jesus. Father, we bless your name. We worship you. Thank you for your mercy.
Amen.
Thank you for your kindness.
Amen.
Thank you for the great things you are doing in our midst.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord, for the brighter tomorrow that we see.
Amen.
Thank you for today.
Amen.
And thank you for where you are taking us from.
Amen.
Give you all the glory and the praise.
All the glory.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Please take your seats in God's presence. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So once again, let's go very quickly. What are the forces that bring about or that facilitate restoration? Force number one. You must have a desire. Amen.
Amen.
Because things happen according to your desires. You know, God doesn't do something to someone because somebody needs it. That person must show that he needs it by expressing their desire. I pray that you are with me.
Oh.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Number two.
Revelation.
What?
Revelation of what you have.
A revelation of what is to be restored. Or what the word of God provides. The revelation that God's word shows you of what is yours and what you can get. Number three.
Faith in God.
Faith in God. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Whosoever comes to God must believe that God is and is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Number four.
Prayer.
The force of prayer. The force of prayer. The force of prayer. The force of prayer. And I pray that by the grace of God, we can go on Sunday into a certain dimension or a certain type of prayer that is very important, that produces results in terms of breakthroughs, in terms of restoration. Number five.
The prophetic.
The force of the prophetic. The force of the prophetic. No matter how bad the situation can be, once the prophetic steps in, things can change.
Amen.
No matter how bad things can be, once the prophetic steps in, things can change.
Amen. Oh, yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Jehoshaphat was facing a situation where he didn't know what to do because now they were about to maybe say starve themselves to death. There was no water. And so, how they could change their situation, the only thing now they needed was the prophetic.
Amen.
He said, is there no prophet around here that we may consult him? They said, oh, there's one that used to pour water for Elijah. And guess what? Something came from heaven. And the situation changed.
My God.
Same like a believer.
Amen.
The situation completely changed. Very important. Number six, what did we say?
The force of steadfastness.
The force of steadfastness. To be steadfast is to be unbendable.
Amen.
To be unwavering.
Oh, yes.
To be at it. Amen.
Amen.
And the force number seven.
The force of gratitude.
The force of gratitude. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
These forces can help us to recover things.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
So today, I'll try to the best that I can by the help of God to just emphasize a few things, or to just emphasize what you already know about this issue of steadfastness. You see, every plant that, or every crop, or every plant, I mean, every seed that you will plant, it will not give you a harvest the same day you plant it. Let's go to Ecclesiastes chapter 3. Amen.
Amen.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, and let us read from verse 1. To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under heaven. That is verse 2. A time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck that which was planted, that is to harvest. Amen.
Amen.
The whole concept of God's creation runs on the seed.
check, check.